If there ever was a blueprint for Yes, I think what it was is that we really wanted to be a very good instrumental band, but also with great vocals.
What we were doing we'd sort of structure everything so that everything had to be note perfect. But that was the exciting thing for a long period of time, watching the musicians learn these intricate pieces of music and relearn and reinvent and stuff. So we were in this wonderful school of music.
Thank you. I think all credit to the guys in the band, all of them, who've kept it going for all of the period of time, for 35 years. I take my hat off to them. A lot of bands have come and gone and come back again and reformed, really, but there's always been a Yes. I think Chris once said in an article, when he was asked by a journalist, who's in the band now, and he said, it'll be the first five who turn up for rehearsal. On all the occasions when people have been away, they've come back a stronger person, able to contribute more by working with other musicians, doing other things. They've filled up their musical shopping basket in the supermarket, shall we say, and come back, and there's more to offer. I think the pure fact that the five of us are completely different is why it works. There's certain lineups over the years that if you add the number of people together, the sum of those is greater than the actual number. There's very few examples when you actually do it with bands that it actually works. But the one which is more astonishing is probably Yes, because unlike the other bands, Yes have had lots of changes. And with the exception of this particular lineup, the five musicians have always added up to five. For whatever reason, you put this five together and it adds up to 10. There's a certain telepathy that goes on musically. There's a certain understanding that goes on musically. And I think there's a certain genuine respect that goes on both on stage and off stage.